Yeah, absolutely. That's a good way of putting it. We've had a ton of guys that have experience both in games and then playing as a unit in practice. And, you know, we've taken advantage, albeit it was a very weird time, of the extra practices. And it's given us a great opportunity to get our assignments, our techniques, our fundamentals sound, and work as a cohesive unit. And, you know, coming from all that extra time together, I feel like we've really grown in that bond and really honed in on our individual assignments and playing together as a whole. And feeling very comfortable with the guys beside me, and I know they're feeling the same, and we're really excited to see what happens this week. The past years at Michigan have been the best of my life, and you know, as a part of this team, seeing guys grow, being able to grow myself has been a very rewarding process, and the coaches and staff that have helped me and all of us along the way. And I've learned from great players. I've had the pleasure of being the footsteps of some really good players and really good mentors and coaches, and you know, just really soaking it all in and you know, trying to improve myself to get to this point, and gonna continue to grow as the season progresses. And you know, wouldn't want to have this opportunity with any other group of people. I'm very excited. Yeah, absolutely. You know, when I asked coach for the opportunity to come back and I was granted it, you know, I was blessed and very excited to have the opportunity, because you never know when football is going to end, and I fully believe I'm taking advantage of every second I still have with it. Well, our coaches did a great job of meeting with every individual player and just, you know, sitting down, talking about what their goals are, what they see for their future, and trying to work something out that's best for everybody. And I really approached that meeting with one thing in mind. I was going to stay around as long as I could, because, like we had been previously talking about, this could have been my last chance. And I felt that I had prepared myself the best as I could, and grown really close with the coaches and my teammates, second family here. And, you know, as long as they'd have me, I'd continue to be here and continue to work. Because at that time, when it first happened, I was thinking, you know, we're going to play eventually. We just don't know when it's going to be. I wanted to be ready for that. Yeah, absolutely. You know, I don't know if I previously said, like, we were all bummed. Like, it was obviously just heartbreaking at the time, because it was a world of unknowns. But you know, pretty much right away, there was a, although we were sad, there was complete buy-in to team improvement, self-improvement, trying to do anything you can to get ready for the next chance that's going to happen, because you never know what was going to come. And you know, as a offensive line unit, I know that kind of went in, because we couldn't really hit. It kind of went into the mental aspect, the fine techniques, the mindset of the game, and growing together and getting on the same page with all that. And you know, the time, the extra time was put to good use that way. You know, we would have loved to play, but you know, making use of whatever chance we had, and we really did take advantage of that time, I believe. He's gotten very, very good at it, and we're all working together, and it's a whole unit out there working as one, I believe, and we're all on the same page, and you know, playing off of each other and bouncing calls. We're just trying to get the best play possible. So, you know, I'm fully confident in my ability, my other lineman's ability, Joe's ability, and everyone up on that's on the field at the time.